Welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. We missed something. I was watching my video back.
Sure.
Poor Eder. If it's what I think it is. I think we can go here and we can go anywhere. We missed an item outside of... What is it called? Cliaban Rilag. Glamfellen soul hunters arrive seeking employment? Is that supplicant or is that somebody else? Send the grieving mother. I look really close, so I said odorless disciple. Oh, that's good. Over here. Now, I'm not completely sure if that's what I'm thinking, and it might be.
Hey, something metal in the ground. Over by that boat.
Oh, maybe it's somewhere else, or maybe it is here. Red Saren Standard Piece. The steel ornament once rested atop a Red Saren Standard during the Saint's War. It is shaped to resemble a rising sun. The tip of some metal object protrudes from a mound of watery river salt. With both hands, you and Eder begin digging in the mud until the object is dislodged. You close your hand around it and pull it from the wet earth. The object is a steel semicircular frame about the size of your fist. At even points around the semicircle, jagged points jut out like tongues of flame, the rays of a rising sun. At the sun's center is the carved silhouette of a vorlas plant.
I've seen these before. They've topped the standards of Raid Ceres. Or did when Wideman was alive. Something. Just not sure what it gets me.
He takes it from you and looks it over, flipping it over and over in his hand. I'm wondering if I was not a cipher, if I'd had... I'd have to have something to say. Kind of wondering what the other classes... Each class must have a thing to say. I'm good with objects. I might be able to glean something from it. He shrugs. It's a thought. A lot of people would have touched this. Standard bearer is a position of honor in most places, but the Red Sarians actually took to fighting for it, what I heard. Serious bunch. It's not a lot to hang hopes on, but hey, we were lucky to find anything at all. He passes the trinket over to you. Let's see what you can see. Better not make anything up, or you'll wake up one morning with snakes in your bedroll. I'm not gonna make anything up. You take the steel sun in one hand and clasp Adair's hand with the other, ignoring his uncertain glance. You close your eyes and concentrate. The sun is bright in your mind's eye, warm with the pulse of collective experience and noisy with the thoughts of the past, of battle, of faith, of home. You drift from voice to voice, thought to thought, Eder's soul a brill vibrant signature with which to locate his brother. One voice stands out amidst the din, brassy and earnest, a shade brighter than Adair's, but unmistakably of the same construction. You have no image of its owner, but his journey is imprinted within the points and curves of the steel sun, and in your mind it opens before you as a path stretching both southward to Gilded Vale and northward over the uneven terrain that joins the Deerwood to the Red Saris. You trace the path back to its origin, far back as you can find, gliding over plains and hillsides to a one-room home in Gilded Vale with a thatched roof and a dirt floor. The path is faint here, its distance in time-rendering images blurry and details scarce. From Gilded Vale it follows a road toward Madmer Bridge, reaching the gates of Defiance Bay before diverting abruptly, cutting northward in a beeline for Red Saris. The path leads to a Red Saran city, regal and austere in the Eder imperial style. It winds through trees and climbs a grand set of stairs into a stately building, passing through pointed archways into what appears to be a throne room. Upon the throne sits a man whose head is pure, blinding light, and as its gaze turns to you, the light drowns out all else. Its voice carries the force of thunder, but its words are impossible to make out in the imprint, echoes of echoes. The voice and light fade, and the path bends backward, carrying you along to a barracks, then back southward, marching into Deerwood and skirmishing along the way. Upon one battlefield the imprint is vivid, and you see a Red Saran standard topped with a steel sun, clutched in the hands of a fallen soldier. You see a young man in Red Saran armor with Adair's straw-colored hair race towards the standard and lift it. The path you've been following clear to see beneath his feet, and as his hand brushes the steel tip, you can hear his thoughts racing in a blur, and they are of his god and his country, and a brother he hopes is far away from this place. In an instant, the thoughts are gone as well as the man, and the standard is passed to another soldier. You pick the path up again as it meanders south and disintegrates in the shadow of Cliaban Rilag. You open your eyes.
Anything? Looked like you were working real hard there.
Your brother got as far as Defiance Bay before turning to Red Saris instead. He met Widwin there. Then he enlisted.
What'd he talk about with Widwin?
Widwin's head was a beam of light.
I figured that. Woden and me had heard enough stories from his uprising to know it wasn't just some tall tale. Doesn't mean he was Aethys. It could have been some wizard's trick. It's what they talked about that's important. What'd they say?
I don't know.
That's not funny. Come on. That metal sun, my brother touched it. You saw where he went. Now what'd he talk about with Widwin? Why'd my brother fight for Raid Saris?
Number three is a little off the hook. I really don't know.
I guess that's it.
Adair's mouth hangs open and his eyes glaze, his forehead creased between his eyebrows. He raises his teeth over his lower lip. His voice is barely a whisper when he says, "Guess that's it." We'll find some other way to know why he did what he did.
I don't think we will. What will we do? Look for more war relics? We were lucky to find this one. Soldiers that fought with him are long dead. The battle was a massacre. Whatever Aethys knows, he's not talking to anyone.
We can go now. I've seen what I needed to see. Interesting. Okay, our cleric's tired. Ironically, yeah, we can actually camp here. Really accurate picture this time. Cool, Hervias has finished escorting Lord whatever. Still dark out? Damn. Yeah, let's get out of here. Oh wait, he has more to say. Hold up. If I'm far away from him, we won't hear him talk.
Hope I didn't seem ungrateful back there in the battlefield. And you went out of your way.
It was important to you.
Got real close. Didn't expect that. And for a second, I thought I was going to finally see some answers. Foolish, of course. And why should I get answers? There's a world of Aethasians out there, don't know if their god's been blown up. Still, man can't help looking back. Guess you'd know that well as anyone.
He claps you on the shoulder. He stares off, focusing on some distant thing, unseen and unrealized.
I might have turned my back on my god when he needed me. That's all I'll ever know.
You did what you had to. Even if Wiedwin was Aethas, his actions were destructive.
His actions didn't seem righteous enough for a god. That's why me and Woden had Wiedwin figured for a pretender. It didn't occur to me that my god might actually mean to do harm to his own. Something to think about, I guess.
Guess so. Alright. Let's get out of here. Oh my god. Everybody. Okay, we have a couple of odds and ends. To take care of. Now, as far as Grimda said, there was an abandoned farm. I looked in Stormwall Gorge. How about in Woodend Plains? I think I remember some kind of farm being there. Now, she's looking for some kind of scroll or book, something like that. Of course, once we get it, I don't know if we even complete the quest because they're hostile towards us now. Since we picked the lock, and got into that back room, they all attacked. And since then, they attack us on sight. So, maybe that farm. I have a feeling we might encounter somebody, so let's just... Not up here right now. And that's an obvious farm down there, so... Or over there. Did we not go in here or something? A thief. Has he seen us? I gotta fix him sometimes.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Yes, and then thieves die. Venka? And Iben? Alright, it's on. Whoa. Igar? Who the hell are these people? Beakwolf? Oh, Beowulf's coming. Iben sounds familiar, though. Alright. Any more? Alright, let's see what we got. Hmm. I want to see if this will work. How about we take over this thief? I'll try to anyway. Is that the only one labeled thief? I guess there's another thief here. He died. Has he killed him already? Yeah, we killed him. Awesome. Well, if they're that easy. Alright, they're not that easy. So that's Aloth. Datas. Oh. Got him. Shield. Holy shield, whatever. Thieves on our side. Oh wow, I don't even want to waste that. Where's, Eder? Oh, standing on the way back. I guess he's... Can I? Data, so... Oh, she's still pending with that. I have actually no idea where Eder is. Hold on, that's him. And all these are dead, so... These guys are pretty easy. A group of thieves have stolen the Scroll of Whale from the Hall of Revealed Mysteries in Defiance Bay. Right. This is the... Grimda said that one of the thieves mentioned an abandoned farm on the path to Deerfoot. Now that the thieves are dead, I can search them for the scroll and return to Grimda. Okay. How do we not encounter them before? Eben's Grimoire? At some point I have to consolidate all these grimoires. It's getting kind of ridiculous. Exametal clothing. Not sure if I've ever seen this. The Exametal Plains are vast and fertile savannas to the north of the Eastern Reach. Although the climate is warm, it is less oppressively humid than the heart of a deer. Exametal clothing is heavily layered using cotton and highly decorated wool in equal measure. Extensive beadwork is another defining feature of exametal garments, found both in jewelry and incorporated into the fabric itself. I mean, maybe we've seen it before. I just don't remember. There's the Scroll of Wail. This ancient scroll is bound with silver thread. The broken wax seal is stamped with the shape of an eye. The scroll at first appears to be gibberish, a collection of symbols and characters with no apparent connection between them. As you study them, however, you could swear that the characters begin to move. Slowly, almost imperceptibly, they shift and crisscross and realign, and you are able to read the text. A simpleton seeks out a wise man said to know the answer to every question. "Please," says the simpleton, "you have to help me. The world terrifies me. I wake each morning, and I don't know why. I make choices each day, and I don't know what will happen as a result. I go to sleep each night, and I don't know whether it'll be my last." When the simpleton finishes, he notices that the wise man is weeping. The simpleton apologizes profusely and asks the wise man what he has said to upset him. The wise man shakes his head and wipes tears from his eyes. He answers, "Some people have all the luck." Huh. Okay. As you take the scroll, you hear a voice. "You have found it. Now lose it again." What? You think this theft was an accident? The voice seems to shift, as if the speaker were constantly changing age, race, and sex. "My relics were never meant to stay in one place for long. They are meant to be lost and found. It is the search that gives a thing value. Take it to the Black Meadow, find the drake that faces east, and bury it neath its skull." The Black Meadow. I just had the strangest experience. I heard a voice in my head and it told me to hide the scroll again. It directed me to bury it in the Black Meadow under the skull of the drake looking east. It sounded like a message from Whale itself. Huh. Well, we might not get their favor back. Naked bodies.
Sure.
I'll give it a rest with that. Ooh. Sun-touched mail of Hiran Wrath. Nice. The paladin Hiran Wrath came across a countryside village beset by ghouls and made it his life's work to rid the world of the undead. He believed that their very existence was a blasphemy against the gods and a scourge on all kith. And, having observed the creatures prowling by night and skulking in dark places, he fell prey to then-common misconceptions about their nature. He had his order create armor that shone with the light of the sun, believing them vulnerable to daylight. Unfortunately, he tested his theory in the cleansing of a crowded, vampire den, discovering too late that the light only alerted the creatures to his presence. Published research by animancers has since dispelled many of the dangerous myths surrounding the undead. I even look at the stats. Grant Sunbeam 3 per rest. -50% poison effect tick rate. And -50% disease. So it just slows down the rain, I guess. Their spells are still going. I like the plus one con on this. Well, I can put it on here as well. And it's kind of fire related. Okay. Ba-doom. Nice. That's annoying. Oh wait, yeah, we can head anywhere from there, right? Black. Sorry, I'm a little distracted. Someone's calling me. Let's put it there and then see. Grieving mother is done. Okay. The eastern one, it says? Oh, the skull of the drake looking east. There's only two, right? Oh wait, there's this one too. Aha, yep. This drake skull faces east. The soil underneath is soft and moist. Bury the skull of a whale. As you cover the ancient skull with the last handful of soil, the shifting voice speaks in your head once more. Well done, Watcher. I buried the skull where whale wished. Grimda will want to know what happened to it, but I'm not sure how she'll take this information. Yeah, me neither, especially since they already want to kill us. I don't know if we'll get a chance to even say anything to her. Back to Defiance Bay. We have something else we have to find there in Ondra's gift as well. A chest or something. Okay, I got some things here. Just hireling payday and stuff. We still have something pending. No, I think we've got to we forgot to start the next thing. Woodland Trails. I'm gonna save here because these people might attack and I don't wanna have to kill anybody else. Hello? Come on, Canna. Go, hello? What if I just ignore them and go all the way to Grimda?
Brave Dalfila.
I don't think it would work, right? I can't. Won't let me. Alright.
I wonder, Alof. Don't you ever feel curious about Isselmir's history?
Not even a little.
But think of the opportunities. You could learn so much about the past.
There are some things I'm happy not knowing.
This thing's probably down in the water somewhere. This is my favorite district. Uh-oh. Oh, it's right there? How do I miss all this stuff? I guess these people didn't appear until the quest was activated. So apparently we're going to be dealing with Walder Three Fingers in some way. Dealing with him. Four people stand gathered around what appears to be a wooden chest. One of them, a grizzled and rough-looking character, looks up at you, then sneers. Took a wrong turn somewhere, did you? Best turn around and walk on. Lefty Lisk? There's a sudden snapping sound from the direction of the chest, and a second, smaller man lets out a frustrated groan. Damn it, that's the second lockpick. He looks up at you and stills. Oh. Walder rolls his eyes and turns to you. You've walked down your last pier.